Hello guys, Brad here again with another fragrance review. Today I have the new one from Christian Dior called Sauvage. And I'm sure you've heard about this fragrance by now. This is the Johnny Depp campaign fragrance. And this is what the bottle should look like if you have the right one. You know, don't be confused with like Eau Sauvage, which is a totally different fragrance. The card says, the new fragrance by Dior, an overdose of freshness, the invigorating top notes of a peppery bergamot, the pure and noble trail of an amber wood. So this is just a 1 ml sample, I believe. I wore this to work on Thursday, and I just saved the rest of it for today's review. This fragrance just came out this year in 2015, around September, I believe. And the note breakdown is very basic. Bergamot, Szechuan pepper, and Ambroxan are what they list at Fragrantica. Now, Ambroxan is some sort of a musk note derived from ambergris. So this fragrance has gotten a lot of talk, some negative, some positive. So I want to give my 2 cents on the matter. I can kind of see where everybody's going with this one. It does definitely kind of fall into that same vein as like a Bleu de Chanel. And when Bleu de Chanel came out, that fragrance got a lot of attack as well. You know, a fine fragrance house like Chanel came out with something that people perceived as being mainstream and generic. And now Christian Dior, another fragrance house known for extremely unique and defined blends like Fahrenheit, Dior Homme, Dior Homme Intense. Now all of a sudden they come out with this fragrance that basically has that, you know, nondescript kind of smell to it. The pepper here is very smooth. It blends in there with the bergamot very well. Definitely has a nice, elegant, refined smell to it. I'm not sure if it's going to get big scores for uniqueness. It does kind of have that mall scent quality to it. You know, when you think of musk, you know, you normally think of, like an animalic, feral animal musk. This here, the musk is very clean. I think some people refer to it as like a laundry musk. You could also think of it as like a mall rat musk. You know, it's just, you know, very clean, elegant musk note here. It's hard to really describe. You know, some people would say that it's unique, doesn't really remind them of anything, but some people might say it reminds them of everything. So it's kind of hard to put a tag on that. You know, it's very smooth. It's pleasant. I like it. But at the same time, because it has sort of this, you know, simplistic, you know, I've smelled this somewhere before, but I'm not really sure where quality to it. It's hard to really convince myself to pull the trigger on this one. And the price point, you know, it's the same as other Christian Dior's. 2 ounce bottle is $72. 3.4 ounce bottle is $89. So, you know, you're going to pay, you know, the same price as you would for other Christian Dior's or Chanel's. But definitely, if you're new to fragrances, this will have an appealing quality to it. Now, I didn't get any compliments on this one when I wore it to work. Actually, when I sprayed it on myself, I was having a hard time smelling it. I remember I sprayed it on myself, smelled myself, and I thought, wow, I can hardly smell that. So I actually put some more on my arm just so I'd have a concentrated blast to sniff. So I'm not really sure how well other people perceived it. I thought it did pretty well in terms of projection. You know, I thought I could smell it on myself for like 4 to 6 hours. But let me get into some scores here. Now the smell, I'm going to give it 7 out of 10. I like the smell, but at the same time, because it has sort of this, you know, familiar aspect to it, it's hard to give it much more than that. Now projection longevity, 7.5 out of 10. You know, I thought, you know, I could smell it pretty easily on myself for a good part of the day. Versatility, And I think this is one of those fragrances that you can pretty much wear anytime. It definitely is elegant enough for nighttime. Probably not strong enough for clubbing, but it's probably a good day wear scent or signature scent for somebody. So let's say 8 out of 10 for that. Price point, I mentioned, you know, $89 for the 3.4. Overall, though, I'm going to give this one 7 out of 10. You know, I think it's a nice, fresh fragrance, a little, you know, spicy bergamot in there with a pleasant, non-offensive musk note in there. You know, it's not something that's probably going to appeal to the average Christian Dior fan, but for the average consumer, definitely something to check into, perhaps purchase for a boyfriend or husband. So that's my thoughts. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys later.